Hey YouTubers, thank you for joining us here on this gorgeous Friday afternoon. We are so excited to be here with you, and hopefully you can join us here during this live. Please comment below and ask questions. We are going to be painting this beautiful table and bench. Now we're going to show you how to use the all-in-one paint product in two different great colors, along with the weathered wood antiquing gel. And we're going to use Corinthian as our accent color on the base. Cappuccino, which is a light, kind of a taupey gray, and we're going to be putting on weathered wood to give it a wood look, and we're going to do that using the True Applicator. So stay with us, we're hooking up our Facebook, and we're going to go live on both, so a little challenging here technically, but we're going to get it done and show you how this looks during this live, so I think you're going to enjoy this one. Stay with us. So are we on our, yep. We're up everywhere,
we're
hey Facebook, thank you all. So we're going to get ready and get going and start off our project here on the bench. That's the first piece. Hello everyone, thank you for joining us here. We are going live tonight to discuss painting on this gorgeous table with a gorgeous iron base. You can see the iron trim here. We're going to be using our color Cappuccino, which is a great neutral tan taupe-ish color, as well as getting it the trim color of Corinthian, which is a darker, warm, kind of a warm, deep gray. And we're going to show you how to create the gorgeous wood grain finish using the Cappuccino as a base coat, putting on our weathered wood using the True Applicator Sponge. First off, let's get started. And we're going to put on our first coat of the Cappuccino color and get that going so it can start to dry and get on our first coat. And we are over pretty much raw wood here. We had, this had multiple coats of paint on it through many years of sitting around and getting painted around here, and we have stripped it. First time we've used a stripper, and Steve did a great job getting that paint off, but we're just going right onto the raw wood because the all-in-one paint contains its own primer. So you don't have to worry about priming even raw wood, but remember when painting raw wood, it may absorb some more additional paint than when you're painting over a surface that may have already been sealed. So that's kind of one thing to keep in your mind. It may require an additional coat. All right, so let's get this on. We're gonna do exactly the same thing to the table itself, but I wanna get this bench going first so you can see it in its entirety as we paint the base. Again, ask questions if you're joining us on our YouTube channel or our Facebook page. Melissa is here, and she'll also be sharing a wonderful coupon for you. And this will be our last big sale of the season before Black Friday. So if you're thinking about trying the all-in-one paint, now is the time to give it a try. So that's our first coat of Cappuccino. We're just going to jump right over to the base. I'm going to come around on that side so you can see what I'm using. And here's our color. You can see that color. It's a real dark color. And it's very close to the iron color. I'm going to trim this piece out on the very edge, as well as all the wood is going to get this gorgeous color on it too. So I'm going to get it going here. Painting right over a stained finish. Lots of times we have questions, can we paint over stain? Yes, you can, even though this is pretty shiny. The only thing I ask you to do is clean well and remove any surface oils, waxes, or anything like that that maybe have been applied to the furniture through the years. So make sure you clean all that away before you start putting on your paint, just so you get a good adhesion. This paint's going to dry really quickly, and you'll see that here because we're going to be ready to put on our second coat before you know it. We put on our beautiful finish that we're going to do. Just in a sec. Can you see all this, everybody? Are you good now? Can you see it again?
Mm-hmm. All right. We are live on Crafty Morning.
Oh, great. Hi, Crafty Morning. I hope you guys are seeing what we're doing here. And let's just show them quickly what we're going to do to this edge. So you can kind of get the vision of the whole piece as we start into the weathered wood in just a moment. Ladies, ask questions. Gentlemen, ask questions if you have any about the all-in-one paint products or what we're doing here tonight. Post them in the timeline. Be sure to share this to your timeline. We would appreciate it. If you you've never painted before, this is the paint product that is a no-fail product for you. That's durable enough for your front door, your kitchen cabinets, your bathroom, your vanity. Anywhere you want to go, you can use this product to renew and refresh anything in your home. Pretty much everything can be painted using this product, except bathtubs. So it's always a common question. Don't paint your bathtub.
All right. So we've got a couple people asking, what our YouTube channel is.
YouTube channel is Heirloom Traditions Paint. You can search anything Heirloom Traditions. You can use all of our matter of fact should come up for Heirloom Paint, but you'll see all of our videos there. And we'll show you how to use all of our products. We have a lot of amazing products. Our kind of brand motto is, we help you restore and refinish every surface in your home. And we try to do it in an all-in-one way. Most of our products are proprietary products that no one has anything like them, like our Bond and Flex product, our new product that repairs leathers and vinyls. You can check that out. We have healing or leathers that are peeling off, the vinyls that are cracking and peeling, you can repair them.
Paula, can you tell us why we're using all-in-one paint for this project?
Well, ladies, we're using all-in-one paint simply because you don't have to do any stripping or sanding. You just want to get your surface smooth. If you were to have peeling or loose paint, remove that. That's the only thing I would warn you against. If it's loose, it can't make loose paint stick, so get all of that off. You don't have to do any waxing. If you're familiar with the term chalk paint, this paint's going to look like a finished, waxed, and sealed chalk paint when it's done, but it didn't require you to do any of that. It's all built in to the paint itself. So that's what it's so easy to use. And not to mention the look and the finish that it gives you is gorgeous. It's not shiny. It's a low luster sheen. So it doesn't look like something your mother or grandmother painted back with a spray can or maybe with a brush and latex. It doesn't have that look. It has an old feel to it, so a very historic, time-worn piece that you see on high-end designer furniture today, and you can create that yourself. And you'll see as this begins to dry, the look that we're going to get from this paint. Are you kind of getting an idea already by seeing what we've got now? We're trying to take this into more of a restoration hardware look by toning down the woods that are here. They're not in great shape. Could have left the wood if we so chose and just put on the grays, but I want to give this more of a modern feel. And the gray was kind of where we wanted to go because we wanted to create this faux grain on the top and also on the top of this bench. But you know, you can do anything with these paints. There's 25 beautiful colors that the Alma paint's available in, and you can check those out by visiting our website. And also, again, we'll be posting a great coupon here in the timeline for you tonight. This will be our last big sale.
And the coupon's 40% off.
40% off.
We very rarely do, so that's a great deal. You definitely got to jump on that. That ends this weekend, so it ends Monday at 11:59 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So make sure you get on our website, htpaint.com, and check that out and use the coupon codes that I'm posting for you.
You can see pretty much we're getting this with one coat right over the wood. And I'm going to go over and peel this back and paint this table in just a minute, but I'm going to get this top coat on so it can begin to dry.
Are we going to stripe the top of that?
I'm going to stripe it now, I think.
Now?
I think so. I'm going to try to do it maybe with it wet. I've never done that before, but we're going to try that.
Why not experiment with my life? Why not?
I like to keep it interesting. For me too.
So far, nobody really has any questions. What's going on tonight, people?
I think everybody's tired and it's Friday, right?
You guys have stuff that you need to paint to get your home ready for the holidays? Before that mother-in-law comes over?
Melissa, you got a great mother-in-law.
I have a great mother-in-law.
You think she's the mean one.
No, I have a great mother-in-law, but my mom had a contentious relationship with her mother-in-law, so that's where I always get that from.
Oh, yeah. That's right. You can have.
Yeah.
Hope for that one.
Sometimes they're just a little nitpicky. You don't have to be bad.
You have possession of their sons. Mm-hmm. So, hey, sometimes they want to be
a little critical that your house is just perfect.
We're not.
We're not. Yeah.
She and I haven't become mother-in-laws yet, so we have to be careful.
I know. We're going to be that one. Because we're both mothers to sons.
Yeah. Only child sons.
Yeah. Oh, it's the worst kind of mother-in-law. We're going to be that mother-in-law.
I know. I'm going to try my best.
Hopefully not for a bit.
I don't want to be that.
I know.
Because I certainly don't have that.
So we've got a question from Teresa. She said, what prep do you have to do for a door painted with a semi-gloss paint? It is a metal door. She wants to use all-in-one.
You don't have to do anything other than give it a good cleaning, and I suggest you do that using Simple Green, TSP, any kind of a household cleaner that's a deep greaser. Just get in there and get it clean really well, and if there's debris or anything stuck to the door, maybe there's, you know, sometimes pine rosin, lots of things settle in the door, debris and dirt and dust all kind of stick to the door when it gets damp and rains and then dirt gets in that. Make sure you clean all that, because you can't expect the paint to stick to any of that. So clean it well and put on your first coat of paint, and I think you'll be thoroughly amazed at the results you get with a first coat, and then the second coat is where it will begin to look fabulous. I'm not going to paint the back because I'm going to show you the front.
So Paul, we've got a couple people that are joining us that are a little confused because we said we're painting the dining table, and we started with the bench.
And we are.
So we're getting to the dining table. We're starting with a little bench that goes with it. Yeah. Just hang tight. We're fine.
Okay, girls. So here we are. We're using weathered wood, and fellas, both weathered wood is our antiquing gel. And the reason we call this antiquing gel, probably looks just like paint. It probably looks like the other paint I'm using. But it's truly not. It is a water-based product, just like our paints. I just tipped up my sponge right onto the jar, and I'm loading my sponge just by tipping it. So I don't have to pour this out into anything. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a soft effect.
It's killing them that you haven't painted this late.
Just by dragging this, okay? And it's going to let it blend and blend right into my paint. And I'm going to give it a wood grain look really quickly. It's killing them.
Yeah. They're like, oh, it looks great except for that leg you forgot.
Oh, I didn't forget it. I just hadn't got there yet because I've got a whole backside to do.
I'm
going
to hit it real quick.
Okay, good. So I'm going to leave the bottom.
Don't strike my face.
I'm going to forget the bottom so she can go do the lower part too, that it's hard.
Leave the lower part for Shorty.
She's a little closer, right. There you go. Short girl. Mm-hmm. Short girl gets the low part of the paint job, right? All right, so you see what I'm doing. I hope you can see this on the camera. You can see this dragging effect. Now, you can drag any color into this.
Oh, it looks great.
You can give this as much swiping as you want. That's kind of up to you. But using this true applicator, it makes creating this faux wood grain so easy and fun. Gives you a great look without just painting it solid. And you can stop when you want. You can spray water into it and even blend more. It's just kind of up to you. Whatever it is that you want to do. All right, so let's set this down and come back and we'll work on this a little more. Yep, just set it right here.
Come on over.
Now, same goes with the paint is tabletop. Please ask questions again if you're just coming on this live. Mm-hmm. And let us know.
Tell us what things you've got to paint in your home and how we can help.
Yeah. If you need help with color selection or...
And Melissa will come over and paint with you. The low
parts.
Alright, well, probably won't get that to happen. All right, so I'm not sure where I'm the most visible, but let's just start right here in the center. And then we can put on as much of the antiquing gel as we want. Or we can leave it white, or we could leave it this beautiful cappuccino color. We so chose to do that. We're painting right over the bare wood. Again, this was stripped earlier because it had many years of stain and paint products on it. But kind of, it's not even look at it any longer. This would dry out very smooth and flat if we just leave it.
I love that color.
It is really pretty and fresh, but it's not white, you know? It goes great in so many color scenarios. Looks great with grays, as well as black and white, and just such a great color.
Ladies, I can't get on a plane to come paint for you, but you're welcome to come here and paint with us. You're always welcome to do that.
And she's going to help you.
And I'll help you here.
You may get some takers. We've had people coming in all day today.
You want to come to Kentucky, that's where we are.
Well, you can see how quickly that we could really get this done. And, of course, we've got some time to go back on the bench and a few things to touch up and do, but we can really knock it out quick
just with a little coat of paint.
Something else you may notice is I'm not really overworking this product. I put on a lot of paint, move it around, and I let it settle itself so it will lay flat. And if you keep overworking this paint product, it's not like latex. It has a mind of its own. So you have to kind of put it on, move it around, not to leave it huddled up. But don't keep going back into the paint once you apply it. Put it down and let it begin to self-level. It's designed to level itself. So you have to let it do that by not tinkering with it. All right, I'm running out of places here. I got it.
Absolutely.
So let's do, if you will say on this page, you got this. That's all you got to type in the comments. You got this. Let's cheer Paula on here. See if she's going to break a sweat working on this. Gosh, this is probably, what, it's 8 foot, 7 foot,
it's 9 foot table? Table.
It's not a small project.
It's an 8 foot table.
Yeah. So tell her you got this, and then we will pick a winner here at the end of the live.
Okay.
And you will win a pint of this gorgeous cappuccino color. How about that?
Deal. And YouTubers, same for you. You can enter as well.
Mm-hmm.
You know what? We're going to give one away on each channel. So
yep.
If you're staying with us live here on YouTube, you can also play to win just by commenting in the comments below.
And then we'll give away one on our page, and then we're also live on Crafty Mornings, so we'll give away one there too. So all you got to do is comment,
three.
You got this. And we also ask, please share this to your timeline if you think this might be helpful to any of your friends that have furniture. They have cabinets, they have doors, they have fireplaces, all that good stuff that they could maybe benefit from seeing this demo. Please share that. We'd appreciate it.
All right. So now, remember, since we're putting on this striping effect on this tabletop, we don't have to make it perfect because we're getting ready to refill finish. And I'm going to do a little sweat. Same thing. Turn this thing up. Again, I'm using the True Applicator sponge. I don't even pour it out. I just tip it up and pour right on my piece. This little tool is so handy. And you can get them on our website. It just gives me a little handle to hold on to so I can kind of keep it vertical to my surface. Vertical. Not vertical. Level with my surface. All right, so we're just going to create this faux grain. Right here.
What do we think so far?
Y'all like this look?
And some like people it. Call it restoration hardware. They call it driftwood, beechwood, weathered wood.
Yep.
Whatever you call it, that's
I
the
call
look
it weathered
it.
Wood.
Mm-hmm.
Because that's the look.
Yep.
And of course, you can do this with four colors of paint. You don't have to do it with these colors.
Mm-hmm.
But the weathered wood is this antiquing gel is semi-transparent, and it stays open longer than paint. So that's what makes it so easy to use. But of course, I'm blending it in the paint, so. Yeah, I'm getting these long swipe marks. It isn't as easy when you get out here and blending. This is a good workout, girls.
We'll just keep blending, blending.
Yeah, you can blend it away or leave it heavy.
Yeah, if it's too stripey for your personal taste, you can dampen that sponge, the True Applicator, and just keep blending.
And
when
you get
it to your mouth.
Come back tomorrow. If you have spots you don't like, take a brush, brush them out, or as it dries, go back and add more of the cappuccino color. There is no rhyme or reason here, and there's no right or wrong. That's the beauty of it. So you can't mess up. Again, we're working with water-based paint, so it doesn't smell. Notice I feathered this end. When I get to the end, I lift the pressure off. And that way you don't see a brush mark. You don't see this tool mark as obvious. So down here, we've got it kind of light, and some more. So you see that? Try to keep your lines straight. That's one thing important that you do. What?
We've got a couple questions. Karen wants to know, could you spray this paint?
Oh, sure, you can spray this paint. But, you know, if you like spraying paint, that's great. But there's one beautiful thing about this paint. It's so easy to work with and self-leveling. You don't even have to put it in a sprayer. And you're going to get fantastic results with a brush, which sounds like a non-truth, but trust me and try it, and then you'll see.
Somebody was else was asking if you could use a roller.
You can. Same rules apply. You know, Same rules again. You can use a roller, sure, but you soak up a lot of paint in a roller. I suggest you try it without a roller and then come back and see what you think. If you've never had great results and you've always went to a roller because of that, try the sponge and then try dampening the sponge a little bit. Sometimes that will help you get a little less tracking in your paint. Colors all really kind of are depending on that too. Certain colors are easier to work with than others. Whites tend to be a little more tracking than others, as usual.
Wesley's saying they wish we could do a chair to go with the table. So it would work the same way, Wesley,
sure.
And that true applicator works great for spindles. It just wraps right around them, and you can knock those out really, really fast. We say it takes the pain out of painting spindles.
Now, it does. Baby beds,
yeah.
Anything that runs a chair or whatever that you dread so bad, wrap around a brush, around something round like that. It's so much easier using this thing. Now, I'm going to keep knocking everything over. I'm going to get the other side. All right, so you liking the colors of this? It looks cool with these lights on it. It's truly not so cool.
That looks great at a distance.
It looks good up
from where I am.
Yeah,
well, I'm not really far.
Sorry to come back to you.
I'm sorry.
You got a big old table, do
you? Keep on. Can you remind everybody who's just jumping on with us the colors and the products and why the products and all that good stuff?
All right, guys, if you're just coming on to the live, we are finishing a dining table and a matching bench. And we're using our all-in-one paint products. We're using the color Cappuccino, which is this soft creamy taupe color you're seeing on the base coat. And right now I am putting on top of that the antiquing gel, which is a product we call weathered wood. And it's letting us have a semi-transparent way to antique this table and to create these striations in this paint and to give it a faux grain look simply by using this true applicator sponge and dragging the paint and the weathered wood together. So it's giving us that great look. Simple.
All right, and no top coat.
No top coat. Once we're done with this, there's no sealers that you need to add to this. And be done.
Have you guys heard of people painting their furniture or their cabinets, particularly painting on this beautiful snow white, and they're all happy with the finish, and then they go to top coat, and it's
wonk,
yellow,
top
nastiness.
Top coats resurrect a lot of lower issues. The chemicals underneath and all that are resurrected by chemicals in a top coat. So the old stains and finishes from the old days don't like the new finishes from today's world. When you interact with the yellow, nicotine, yellows, lots of stuff, and top coats bring that out. So this product has the top coat built in, and you don't have that extra step, and you also don't have the extra brush marks that top coats leave behind in the layers. So the beautiful thing is I can go home and be done with this.
I like that.
Ready to go home.
I'm all about eating. It ain't easy. I ain't doing that.
I'm trying to get this edge for you. I'll go back and darken this edge, but I just want to put something on there so you can see what weathered wood will do.
What do we think, guys?
Just rubbing
it. Like
off.
This look? I mean, she just did an 8 foot by 4 foot, maybe 5 foot tabletop in what? 10 minutes?
4 by 8. Yeah. And
right.
A bench.
Yeah. And a bench. And a bench of 25. And talk to it all.
Hey, that's a feat.
That slows us down. So you got to imagine, you can do it a little bit faster.
Yeah. All right, so that's it. Now, I just press that into the edge and rub
it
away.
Make sure you're entering the giveaway. You just say, you've got this.
I think you can see it great. I'm glad you can see it great on YouTube as well. All right, guys, so please post questions here, and we will edit this video and post this back into our YouTube pages so you can see the whole fabulous finished piece once it's dried and once we get everything painted and the base coat on. And if you are on the live tonight, be sure and take note of the giveaway that we have that Melissa's been posting. And the only thing you have to say here is what?
You got this.
You got this. If you post "you got this" in the timeline, you are entered to win in tonight's giveaway here on YouTube as well as on our Facebook page and on Crafty Morning. So keep posting, keep sharing, and let us know what you think of this table and the bench. And again, we'll post those finished pieces back here so you can see them too. And don't forget about our 40% off by using the coupon code that Melissa is posting right here in the table.
timeline, so ask questions, keep going, we'll keep checking.
And that makes, I'm trying to think, I didn't do the math ahead of time, but that makes a pint about $23, $24.
Wow.
It's normally $38.99, so.
Remember, that gets your wax, your top coat, and everything all in there, and you don't have to buy anything else, nor your time and your energy spent on doing anything else. This is a very durable product that will work for your front door, your shutters, and anything else that you have that is needing painting. So pretty much you can use it everywhere and get a great durable finish. So not only is it for, this one is right in the middle, so it's cut my head off on some YouTube channel. But anyway, thank you so much. And
let's pick some winners here.
Right, we're gonna
okay.
pick some winners.
On the Crafty Morning page, I'm picking Wesley Tennyson.
All right, Wesley Tennyson.
Some great questions.
You are the winner, Wesley Tennyson. You are the winner on our Facebook page.
So you win a pint of the cappuccino paint. Just reach out to us on the Heirloom Traditions paint page, not on the Crafty Morning page. So just come over to our Facebook page and shoot me a message.
All right.
And then for our page,
and for Heirloom Traditions, we're also giving the giveaway away as well.
And that is going to be Georgia's Creations.
Georgia's Creations. I'll take
it.
You're a
page.
Good deal. Awesome. I'm glad you posted that, Georgia. Thank you so much. And we will, again, communicate with us on Heirloom Traditions. Just message us there in Messenger on Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
And you can communicate with Melissa the color you would like, mm-hmm. all of you winners. And you got the YouTube winner?
I don't know. How do I see the YouTube?
Oh, we'll let YouTube pick the winner. I'll post that later tonight because YouTube will select a winner for us. It will let us pick a winner.
Remember, guys, please share this to your timeline. If you're going to order paint, you'll want to be able to find this, and it's very difficult to find it on either our timeline or Crafty Morning's timeline because we both post so much. So just make sure to share it to your timeline. It'll be really easy for you to find when you're ready to start your project.
All right, ladies. Guys, thank you all so much for joining us here. We appreciate your time and appreciate everybody for sharing this tonight. Thanks again.
Bye.
Thank you. Please like and subscribe to our channel, YouTubers. Thank you.